Well, I am very happy to be here today with you, Ms. Anessa Ahmed, who's just won the Secretary's International Women of Courage Award. And we wanted to just talk a little bit more about the reasons why you won the award and some of the wonderful work that you've been doing in the Maldives. One of the things that Secretary Clinton talked about yesterday was the really tremendous efforts that you undertook when you were the Deputy Minister for Women's Affairs about domestic violence and how you really began to help people understand why this is an important issue to address. Could you talk a little bit about that?
When I was working in the government, we realized, because we were working very closely with women, we realized, how many women actually were victims of violence. And when the survey was done, it revealed that one in three women in the country at some stage in life did actually experience some form of violence, either physical or psychological.
And do you feel that attitudes are already changing in the Maldives on this issue?
Well, I wouldn't say that. Uh-huh. I wouldn't say that. We need to educate. We believe, in our organization, we believe that everybody has to be sensitive to this issue. Everybody must understand what the implications of, violence. It's not just one person that's being affected, because the whole family is affected, and then, broadly speaking, the community and the entire nation will be affected by it.
And then after you left government, you set up your own non-governmental organization that is also working on many of these issues.
Exactly. That's what it's our organization which is doing this now.
Yes.
Like, I retired early. And I thought I would take some rest. But then I realized, in my view, I created a vacancy, sort of, somebody had to do something about this thing. So I thought, now from civil society, I was started, I'll be able to work with the people and then come up and, overcome or try to overcome some of the problems the government was having in addressing these issues. That's why we created this organization called Hope for Women. And basically, it's aimed at ending violence against women and girls. But the broader objective is promoting gender equality and empowering women.
Yeah, well, I really congratulate you on all of your dynamic work in this area, and it really is making a difference. Tell me just one more question. What was it like for you sitting among all these women yesterday at this ceremony? It was, from my perspective, somebody watching all of you up there, it was a tremendous and very energizing experience to see such a broad range of women doing so many exciting things. But I wonder what it felt like for you.
I felt quite proud of myself, first of all, because what I've been doing for my people in the country, I felt, was not given adequate recognition.
Yes.
I felt, Secretary of State and the U.S. administration recognizing that and,
yes,
giving me this award, it's just, it's incredible. I felt very, very happy, very honored.
Well, anyway, a very warm congratulations to you and to your country for all of the progress that you're making in these areas. So thank you.